Hello students, in the last lecture we have seen about the process control and the discontinuous type of controller, that is on-off controller. Now we will see the electronic version of on-off controller, that is using op-amps. As you can see in the diagram, here input voltage is provided to the inverting terminal of the summing amplifier. If this input Vin reaches to the value VH, then the comparator will go to on state, which is defined as some fixed value V0. You can say at Vout is equal to V0. Okay. Then if this input voltage Vin falls below a value VL, then the comparator will switch to off state, which is defined as 0 volt. Comparator output switches states when the voltage on its input V1 is equal to set point voltage, that is VSP. So mathematically, the on state of the controller is given by VH is equal to VSP. Here SP is the set point, okay, and the off state of the controller is given by VL is equal to VSP minus R1 divided by R2 into V0. So here the characteristic of on-off controller is shown, which is nothing but the relationship between input and output voltages of the circuit. This characteristic indicates that there are only two states of the output voltage, that is 0 volt and V0. Neutral zone can be adjusted by varying the value of the resistor R2. So you can see the neutral zone is in between VL and VH. Advantages of on-off controller. There are only two output states, that is on state and off state. It is simple in construction as well as its cost is low. Then disadvantages of on-off controller. Response of on-off controller is slow, not suitable for the complex system. There is another type of control mode called as floating control mode. In a floating control, the specific output of the controller is not uniquely determined by the error. If the error is zero, the output does not change but remains or floats at whatever setting it was when the error went to zero. When the error moves off zero, the controller output again begins to change. The floating mode controller is of two types, single speed and multi speed. In single speed floating mode, the output of the control element changes at a fixed rate when the error exceeds the neutral zone. And in the multi speed floating mode, not one but several possible speeds are changed by the controller output. Usually the rate increases as the deviation exceeds the certain rate. Now we will see the continuous controllers, which are most obviously used in the practical or real world domain. So the continuous controller modes are proportional controller mode, integral controller mode and derivative controller mode. Here are the output responses of these three modes for the step input signal. The first shows the input and output response of proportional controller mode. Here you can see in the proportional controller, the output is proportional to the input error signal. In the integral controller mode, the output is integration of input error signal, and in the derivative controller mode the output is derivative of input error signal. So that is shown graphically here. So let us first see the proportional control action. In case of the proportional controller, the actuation signal is proportional to the system deviation. If the system deviation is large, the value of the manipulated variables is large. If the system deviation is small, the value of manipulated variable is small. See here, system deviation means the difference or the error signal given as input to the system, and manipulated variable means the output variable. The time response of the proportional controller in the ideal state is exactly same as the input variable. Then proportional control action. So you can see here, system deviation, that is input, is x0 and manipulated variable is y0, and that is proportional to the system deviation. In proportional control mode, a smooth linear relationship exists between the controller output and the error. The range of error to cover the 0% to 100% controller output is called as the proportional band, because the one-to-one correspondence exists only for errors in this range. The output can be expressed as P is equal to Kp into Ep plus P0, where Kp is proportional gain between error and controller output. P0 is controller output with no error. In proportional controller mode, the proportional band is dependent on the gain, and it can be expressed as PB, that is proportional band, is equal to 100 divided by the constant Kp. So here the proportional band of a proportional controller depends on the inverse of the gain. You can see in the diagram there are two gains. First is narrow band and second is wide band. And for the narrow band, the gain is G1, and for the wide band, the gain is G2, which is less than G1. Then the characteristics of proportional control mode. If error is 0, the output is constant and equal to P0. If there is an error, for every 1% of the error, a correction of Kp percent is added to or subtracted from P0 depending on the sign of the error. There is a band of error about 0 of magnitude Pb with which the output is not saturated at 0% or 100%. So these are the characteristics of proportional control mode. So proportional control mode is not used, or it is not alone used in the practical applications, because of the offset problem. An important characteristic of proportional controller mode is that it produces a permanent residual error in the operating point of the control variable when a change in the load occurs. This error is referred to as an offset. It can be minimized by keeping the constant Kp larger, and which will also reduce in the proportional band. But to avoid this residual error, the proportional controller is not alone used. Okay, in practical applications, it is either used with integral mode or with derivative mode. When it is used with the integral mode, it is known as PI controller. When it is used with the derivative mode, it is known as PD controller. And in most of the applications, proportional, integral and derivative are used together and it is known as PID controller. So here, that is the offset error. Okay, it requires a new zero error output following the change in the load. It is shown here how the offset error occurs. So here the example of proportional controller is shown. It is known as car steering analogy. Check the distance from the middle of the lane and correct steering in proportion to the distance from the desired position so that the car will move in the linear direction. So here is electronic version of the proportional controller. The proportional controller is designed using the op-amp. Okay, so it is the combination of summing amplifier and the inverter. The output of summing amplifier is connected to the inverter circuit as input. Input to the summing amplifier is the error voltage and output voltage is with zero error. The output voltage of the proportional controller is given by Vout is equal to Gp into Ve plus V0, where Vout is the output voltage, Gp is equal to R2 divided by R1. That is gain, Gp is proportional gain. Then Ve is error voltage and V0 is output with zero error. Then advantages of the proportional controller. Its construction is simple since the two op-amps are used. Okay, then these controllers has high loop gain, it has steady state tracking accuracy, it improves the disturbances signal reduction, it stabilizes the gain and makes the system more stable. So these are the advantages of proportional controller. Then disadvantages. It cannot accommodate the load change without sustained deviation. Then it produces the constant steady state error. Okay, it is the big disadvantage of this proportional controller. For very large gain, it leads to instability of the system. It has a sluggish, that means slow response for wide proportion band. It makes the system less sensitive to the parameter variation.